The famous kombucha, the elixir of life. What could be more natural than taking a tea infusion, adding a bit of sugar and a little fruit, and then letting it be fermented by good bacteria, good yeast, all things probiotic? It's a winning formula. But watch out, there may be risks. My name is Tony Savard. I'm a research scientist in microbiology with Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada, and I invite you to visit our lab and talk about kombucha. My role right now, my challenge, is to work on documenting the functional properties of kombucha to ensure that the industry survives and continues to develop. But more importantly, to ensure that consumers have everything they need to have a healthy product in their hands. I have never seen so many methods or tools on the internet for home fermentation. So there are two kombucha trends that are emerging. There is a craze for a shelf product produced by industries, but there is also this message to do it yourself at home. That's kind of where we come in too. We really want to document the procedures, set limits, establish zones of risk. For example, we know that kombucha is a fermented drink, so it's acidic. We tell the consumer, if you make it at home and after a week your product still has a pH of 5, it's still not acidic, don't drink it. So there's an educational aspect to it as well. And our role is really in that area, providing Canadians with the best possible knowledge of a product, with scientific data to support it.